So James Carville, folks, was one of the first people that came out and said that Biden ought to step aside, make way for a lot of the other Democratic talent that's out there, namely Democratic governors. Well, he's changed his tune. He's not saying that anymore. And I want to answer the question as to why, although he doesn't tell us why. And he raises another point that I think is important that we need to talk about as well. But the whole answer to why he changed his tune, I think, is going to come to us from Ari Emanuel, Rahm Emanuel's brother, who is one of those mega donors and is circulating, obviously, in the Democratic mega donor class. And I think his input is pretty much spot on here. But before we get there, folks, I got this clip I got to play you of Donald Trump. He's obviously in the golf cart. And does this make any sense? Let me play this.
It's a bad guy. He just quit, you know. He's quitting the race.
Is that right?
Yep, I got him out of the race. Wow. And that means we have Kamala. Wow. I think she's going to be better. She's so bad. She's so pathetic.
It's so amazing.
It's just so fucking bad. So
I just can't imagine.
But can you imagine that guy with dealing with Putin and the president of China, who's a fierce person? He's a fierce man. A very tough guy. And they see him, they probably they can't. But they just announced he's probably quitting.
Good.
So he starts off the whole thing by telling everybody that he thinks that he's going to be running against Kamala Harris. And then he goes on this little rant about Biden. And can you imagine him being in front of President Xi of China or Putin? And then he sort of, you know, it kind of trails off a little bit as he, I think, understands that, well, it's not really even worth bringing up if you're not running against him. But another example here, folks, that there's something that's not quite clicking up there. And the one thing, obviously, is that if Kamala were to be the front runner, that whole age focus would be funneled on this guy who's not, I don't think anyway, in my personal opinion, that he's prepared to deal with that, especially after saying stuff like this. But here's James Carville, folks. Have a listen to this, and we'll talk about it on the other side.
Busy and been trying to catch a lot of knives out there. This is what, so Yogi Berra famously said, predictions are hard to make, especially about the future. But I'll go ahead and get out on a limb and risk making a fool of myself, which is always something, but, you know, really I don't care that much. This is what I think is going to happen. I think that President Biden is going to face the inevitable and is going to announce that he's not running. And concurrent with that, I expect him to endorse and urge the Democratic Party to pick his Vice President Harris to be the party standard bearer. I then think there's going to be a lot of well-meaning effort, and people are going to say, we don't need, the last thing we need is to have some kind of, after all the trauma that the party's been through, the last thing we need is to have any kind of contentious fight or any kind of division at our convention. It's a time for the Democratic community to come together, join forces, and defeat the scourge of Donald Trump. And I think you're going to see a lot of people saying that. And that people are going to say, I'm listening to people say, well, you know, the party's not equipped for that. We can't have a convention like that. We don't have the infrastructure for it. We don't have it's all very valid. And what Donald Trump is going to say is, I ran in 2016, bet they all ran against me. The whole little Marco, the whole thing. You know, I didn't keep them out, I beat them out. And when I ran in 2024, they sent them all out there. And I didn't try to get everybody out to race, I just won. And now, and can tell you what he's gonna say, that the Democratic Party is controlled by a cabal of coastal people that shut everybody out. It's just like I told you, that's all they care about. And you know what? You can be your own judge as to whether or not you think that is going to be effective.
And so the thing there, folks, is that the thing I want to talk about first is that cabal. You know, Donald Trump is no doubt going to come out and say, listen, they're forcing Kamala Harris onto you, and, you know, you shouldn't let him do that and all this kind of stuff, because that's what he does. But there's a lot more behind why that has to be the case. And I want to play this clip, folks. And again, this is Ari Emanuel, and he'll give us some insight into that.
His cohorts have told us that he's healthy for over a year. And I think it was 2 weeks ago, there was an article in the Wall Street Journal. And I had a father who died at 92, but at 81, I took away his car. And it's a very simple test for me. If you were driving from, anywhere they understand it, from downtown Beverly Hills to Malibu, would you want Biden to do it at night? Would you want Trump to do it at night? Or not? Neither. If the answer is neither, you cannot have them running a $27 trillion company called the United States.
Okay.
And then we sat in a situation where he went to France for the 80th anniversary and talked about the sacrifice that those soldiers made for us. So he has said, you know, and his cohorts have said, he's the only one that has defeated Trump. It does seem like Donald Trump said, I'm the only one, I alone can save, make all these problems go away. And now Biden is saying, I'm the only one that can beat Trump. Seems like it's pretty similar here. And we have a great bench in the Democratic Party. And so we're looking at a man who's saying the other guy's a liar, and he's telling us malarkey, his people are telling us malarkey, but we're in a very bad problem. He is not the candidate anymore. I mean, if you all remember, this is a legal issue now. He was gonna get kicked off the ballot in Ohio. They elected him the candidate. So you no longer can remove him. In three swing states, Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, and Michigan, there's only one Democratic Congress, Michigan. They have to vote to remove him. I don't believe the Republican Party in Pennsylvania and in Wisconsin are going to do that. Okay, and if they do, it's then Kamala Harris. This is legal. So lawyers have to look at this. And everybody says, well, get rid of him and brokered convention. No. Now, maybe the delegates, there's some question whether the delegates can do something. And I promised myself I wasn't going to swear. So we're in this is a pickle.
So there's the answer, folks, is that, you know, as he mentioned, a lot of these states may not vote on anyone else to come into the race. Republican states, you know, is obviously it's a revenge thing, and they don't want to do anything to help the Democrats. So that's a problem. And then the other part of it is, you know, the money can only flow to Kamala. You know, the millions of dollars that have been raised can only flow in that direction. They can't flow all of a sudden into another candidate. So that's why James Carville has changed his tune, but it also gives credence to the fact that no, the choices that we have, if Joe Biden should make the choice on his own, that he does not want to run and will step down, the only choice that we do have is Kamala, which isn't, by the way, a bad choice. I mean, she polls so far very nicely against Donald Trump. And I think that's somebody who obviously can push the age issue back onto Donald Trump. But that's kind of what's going on here. So it's not a situation where Donald Trump will come out and say, you know, this is being pushed on you. No, it's nothing like that, folks. But that gives you some background as to what's happening and why things are happening like they are and why Kamala is the one. Till next time, folks.